cuts the waves. I mean, they just don't stick to him. He goes through the water. He believes what he believes. He says what he believes. Some of it's right, some of it's wrong, and a lot of it doesn't make sense. I don't know if you saw the latest information John McCain's put out on his tax plan, on his economy plan. And he's going to cut taxes. He's going to solve the alternative minimum tax. He's going to extend the Bush tax cuts. And he's going to give it a gasoline tax. It's all good. It all sounds good. But when you add it up, it doesn't make sense. It's pure John McCain. This is a Mr. Integrity who will basically say anything to get elected. And if he gets elected, God help the United States of America. Really. So we got to have your help here in South Dakota. We got to sort out the Democratic nomination. I know we will. I agree with what Jack Billion said. This Democratic nomination and this process of going through this from state to state to state is one of the most wonderful things that's ever happened to the United States of America. In state after state, people who before they just didn't get engaged. The nominating process was something that happened in a couple of states. It was over in less time than it took for the World Series to be completed. And then you were given your nominees, and then you picked them, and that was it. And the political season started basically sometime at the end of September, after you got your first college football games underway, and it was over in early November. Now Americans have a chance to really get engaged. I don't care whether you're for Hillary or Barack. It doesn't matter. What matters is that you're reaching out there and you're helping people to think about the issues, what our country needs, what our candidates can bring to it, and you're motivating and enlisting and building this electorate and this Democratic Party for this election in November, because we must win. I wish we weren't in the position that we're in. I wish we could stand up today and say, boy, our country, we're just in such great shape. All we got to do is keep it rolling. But we're not. And to figure out where we really need to go, you have to understand how we got here. It's a pretty simple story, really. We came out of the Cold War, 40 years of Cold War, people my age, we never thought the Cold War would end. And I know that many of you, can I ask all the veterans who, whether you're a veteran of a war, whether you served in the Cold War, World War II, Korea, Vietnam, the Gulf War, Iraq, or anything in between, if you served in uniform, would you please stand up and let us recognize you? Look at this. Would you look at this crowd? Thank you, veteran. Thank you for your service. Thank you. And Senator Tim Johnson, let me just thank you again for what you're doing for our veterans, for your constant pressure and push to make sure our veterans have their VA benefits, their educational benefits, and are treated with the respect that this country holds them. Thank you, sir. We won the Cold War. It was an incredible victory that people my generation never would have imagined would happen. We had a strategy during the Cold War. It was a strategy of containing the expansion of communism and deterring an attack by the Soviet Union. We had our Strategic Air Command at places like Ellsworth Air Force Base wearing a patch on their sleeve that said, "Peace is our profession." And the men of SAC and women of SAC would tell you that if they ever had to use their weapons, they would know we had failed. We built a great strategy on a bipartisan basis. It was a military strategy. We built the military-industrial complex. We had the R&D tax credits. We brought tens of thousands of youngsters from overseas to come to our universities so they could learn our values and go back home and represent democracy and freedom and human rights in their countries. We used American business abroad to hire locals and then bring them in to our way of life and our business community, where we're honest, where we're not corrupt, where you're advanced on merit. We sought every advantage from international law. We were the founders and proponents of the Geneva Convention and the changes in the Geneva Convention. And we reached out and built alliances. principally with our Europeans, but across the world, because we knew that the challenge of the Cold War was greater than any single nation could handle all by itself. And it was a strategy that worked. Democrats and Republicans never totally agreed on this. I mean, the Republicans were always like, you know, let's have more weapon systems and let's talk tougher. And Democrats were always like, can't we just agree and talk to our adversaries a little bit? But there was a strong bipartisan consensus at the core of this that kept the country moving. And it worked, and we won, and we defeated the Soviet Union. In 1989, the Berlin Wall fell. By 1990, these satellite nations of Eastern Europe that had been occupied since World War II by Soviet troops were throwing off these Soviet satellite governments. They were demanding democracy. By the end of 1991, the Soviet Union itself had completely fallen apart. We won. We never fired a shot directly at the Soviets, at least that we knew about publicly. And we won with a strategy of deterrence and containment. But when we won, we not only defeated our adversary, we lost our adversary. We lost our strategy, it no longer quite made sense, and America more or less lost its way in the world. I was called to Washington in 1994 to become the Director of Strategic Plans and Policy. I'd read Francis Fukuyama's book about this being the end of history. I'd listened to George H. Bush talk about a new world order. I'd seen the fact that we'd used our troops to get rid of Noriega in Panama and to free Kuwait from Saddam's invasion in 1991. And obviously the Soviet Union was falling apart. I'd been at Fort Hood, Texas, 17,000 troops, 350 tanks, 350 Bradley fighting vehicles, a battalion of Apache helicopters, four battalions of artillery, and a whole bunch of trucks and stuff, and 53 horses, and...